90s. Our hair was big, our outfits were tiny, and our brows were thin. It was a simpler time.
Whatever.
Instagram didn't exist, and supermodels like Cindy Crawford and Claudia Schiffer made damn sure the only brand you wanted to paint your face with was Revlon.
It won't kiss up on him or him.
Try living with outrageously beautiful hair every day of your life. You'll get used to it.
Revlon has honestly been one of the most iconic brands. I remember growing up and stealing my mum's Revlon lipstick. They were so known for, you know, vibrant reds, vibrant nails.
Now, Revlon is going the way of other 90s relics like Furbies, answering machines, and this bloke.
Beep, da, 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 da.
The pandemic delivered the first big blow to sales, a drop of 21% in 2020.
What?
In the first quarter of this year alone, Revlon suffered a further net loss of $95 million. Now, with debts estimated between $1.4 and $14 billion, it's filed for bankruptcy.
We've gone through this huge shift now where, you know, we're really focusing on skincare and we're focusing on natural beauty sort of shining through and not really wearing such heavy makeup.
The company has tried to revive itself, recruiting fresh faces like Gal Gadot.
Let it be unforgettable, just like me.
And Megan Thee Stallion.
Look how that lash just really turned the look up.
All while trying desperately to carve out a space in the super competitive beauty blogging sphere.
Hey guys.
Let me show you guys how I did it.
But Revlon keeps losing core customers to major rivals L'Oreal and Estee Lauder, while millennials and Gen Zers turn to brands owned by their favorite celebs.
This year is really about realizing stuff, just like realizing things.
People are looking for products that do both in one. So we're tying cosmetics and we're tying skincare, you know, into products that do one thing. We're seeing huge shifts in the industry towards clean beauty as well.
If a court approves, an $815 million lifeline from lenders is on the way to save this sinking ship. But if sales continue to plummet, is the lipstick writing on the mirror?
Because we women deserve it all.
Revlon.
It's interesting because Revlon in many ways really did define makeup in the 80s and the 90s. And I wonder if it's one of those things, a bit like the Bee Gees during the whole Staying Alive era. Yeah. They defined music in the 70s and they were so on the outer for decades afterwards.
Their makeup brand went under as well.
That's
so
true.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to happen to all of us.
Same way.
Yeah.
But what Revlon didn't do was what one of the big companies like Estee Lauder did, when I think back to my days of magazine editing, and they were the two biggies, Revlon and Estee Lauder. Estee Lauder bought up all the young, groovy competition like MAC. So they controlled the market, and I think Revlon was just sort of on the back foot for too long. And all of those brands like Zoe Foster Blake's Go To, and they're young and groovy. And of course, Kylie Jenner has just been busy realising things
all year. That's
whatever
that
was.
Revlon, of course, also makes excellent hair products for detanglement and volume. So if they go under, I am devastated.
Yeah, devastated. Poor thing.